Hi guys, as you may already know, dimensions in a data warehouse may contain attributes with static data. But how can we manage a dimension whose attribute values changes? Well, today I'm going to introduce you to slowly changing dimensions. And at the end of this video, you would know what is a slowly changing dimension, the importance of slowly changing dimensions, and the types of slowly changing dimensions that exist. So what is a slowly changing dimension? It is a dimension that tracks both current and historical data over time in a dimensional data warehouse. And there are several types of slowly changing dimensions. I'm going to introduce you to five different types. And the first one I'm going to talk about is type 0. With slowly changing dimension type 0, the dimension attribute values never change. This is typically seen in most attributes in a date dimension. This is a date dimension, and we have attributes day name, month name. We all know that day name never changes, as well as month name. So if you have these attribute values in your table, then you don't expect these values to change. And this type of dimension is called the type 0. The second type of slowly changing dimension is type 1. With type 1, if there is any change in any of the attribute values, old values in the dimension is overwritten with the new values. So in type 1, the attribute values always reflect the most recent information. And here, no history is kept. This is an example of how type 1 looks like. So we have the original dimension table, and then the employee name Bill Lyon is changed. Instead of keeping track of when Bill Lyon changed his name to something else, we decide to just replace Bill Lyon with the new name, which is Bill Tiger. So this will be our new dimension. We overwrite the old values with the new values. This is called type 1. The third type of slowly changing dimension I'm going to discuss with you is the type 2. Here, in order to track changes in a dimension, we add a new row to the dimension table with the updated values. This is the most widely used slowly changing dimensions in a data warehouse. And here is an example of how it looks like. We have our original dimension table here, and because we are dealing with type 2, we introduce at least three additional columns. We have start date, end date, and current status. All the attributes are still current, so it's yes for all of them. However, if employee name changes for Bill Lyon, then we introduce a new role and capture the new name for Bill Lyon, which is Bill Tiger. And because we already have three additional columns, we are able to track when Bill Lyon changed his name. So the status is no, and the status is yes for Bill Tiger. So this is how slowly changing dimension type 2 works. And like I said, this is the most popular type of slowly changing dimension implemented in dimensional data warehouses. The fourth type of slowly changing dimension we have is the type 3. Here, instead of introducing a new row, we introduce a new column. I must say that this is less frequently used because there is a limit to the number of columns you can add to a table, and you also need to go through management in order to be adding columns each time a dimension attribute values changes. So this is how it looks like. So here, Bill Lyon decides to change his name. So we would introduce a new column and capture the new name there, which is Bill Tiger. So we have the initial column existing, and then a new column is added. And we just keep on adding new columns if any of these attributes changes. Next, we have the type 4. This type of slowly changing dimension is used when a group of attributes or an attribute in a dimension rapidly changes. So if we have one particular attribute changing more frequently, then we need to split that attribute out of the main dimension table and create a mini dimension for it. So suppose that we had employee age in this employee dimension, and then we realized that the age of the employees just keep changing rapidly, then we need to take it out of this original employee dimension and create a new dimension for it and have its own key. And then what you need to do is represent both primary keys in the fact table together with all the other attributes of the fact table. These are types of slowly changing dimensions I want to introduce to you guys today. There is a saying that practice makes man perfect. If this is new to you, then I recommend that you keep watching this video and you keep practicing it so that you can become more proficient in using these slowly changing dimensions, whichever that you want, or as recommended by the business. Thank you so much for watching this video and have a great day.